This chapter will cover variable costing and full costing. These are two methods of determining which cost will be included as product cost and which cost will be included as period cost. We know that inventory includes all costs necessary to get products ready to sell. There are two methods of determining product cost. Full absorption costing is required for GAAP reporting. We typically refer to this as full costing. It emphasizes the cost function, meaning product versus period. Variable costing is used for internal decision making, and it emphasizes cost behavior, fixed versus variable. The variable costing method helps managers make product decisions that is easy to predict how cost will behave in the future. Merchandising companies buy products and sell them, and their product costs are reported on the income statement as cost of goods sold and on the balance sheet as one single inventory account, typically referred to as merchandise inventory. Manufacturing companies buy materials to produce products, and ultimately, once those products get produced, they are able to sell them. Product costs are reported in three inventory accounts on the balance sheet: raw materials, work in process, and finished goods. On the income statement, cost of goods sold is reported as a single line item. Full costing includes direct materials, direct labor, and variable manufacturing overhead and fixed manufacturing overhead as part of inventoriable cost. Variable costing includes only the three variable costs. Note the difference. Full costing does not include, or variable costing does not include, fixed manufacturing overhead. Other than that, the same cost components are included. There are two forms of income statements: the full costing income statement, where costs are reported based on function, product versus period. There is an important subtotal called gross margin. You're probably familiar with this from your financial accounting class. Sales minus cost of goods sold equals gross margin. Gross margin is the amount available to cover operating expenses and to contribute towards profit. Variable costing income statement, the costs are reported based on behavior, fixed versus variable. There's also a very important contribution margin subtotal. It's the amount available to cover fixed cost and to go towards profit. The two ratios carry a lot of weight, and they'll be used a lot in this course. The gross profit ratio you should be familiar with from financial accounting. We take the dollar amount of gross profit and divide it by sales. The contribution margin ratio parallels that. We take the contribution margin dollar amount and divide it by sales. These two have different meanings. The contribution margin ratio indicates the portion of every sales dollar, a percentage, available to cover fixed cost and to go towards profit. Gross profit ratio, the portion of every sales dollar available to cover operating expenses and to contribute towards profit. If we look at the GAAP income statement, the full costing income statement, we see that based on function, the product costs are included in the cost of goods sold section. The period costs are included or reported as operating expenses. Gross profit, $67,000 divided by the sales of $100,000. 67 cents out of every sales dollar is available to cover operating expenses and to contribute to profit. The expanded variable costing income statement, there are two sections. Variable cost appears separate from fixed cost. Contribution margin is here in the center. If we divide the contribution margin of $40,000 by sales of $100,000, we have 40 cents out of every sales dollar available to contribute towards profit and towards covering our fixed cost. The contribution approach is very useful in helping us see how the effect of selling additional dollar amounts of revenue or additional products will help us determine how much profit will change. Take, for example, the Element Skateboard Company. If it sells 500 skateboards at $500 each, these must be mighty sweet skateboards, revenue will be $250,000. If variable costs are $300 each, the contribution margin per unit is $200. This tells us for each additional skateboard sold, profit will increase by $200. Fixed cost in total, remember, do not change. We can also look at it from a revenue perspective. The contribution margin ratio is $200 divided by $500, or 40%. We get the same answer whether we do it per unit or in total. $100,000 divided by $250,000 gives us the same 40%. This information tells us that for each additional sales dollar generated by Element, profit will increase by 40 cents, or 40%. Again, fixed cost in total do not change. This concludes Chapter 3, Variable Costing and Full Costing.